There we go. Hi, my name is Nick Roman, but most people call me Roman. I'm 33 years old, and welcome to my office. Yes, I'm in the parking lot of a grocery store, but because I'm a writer, everywhere is my office. So basically, my dream, I've had three dreams in my entire life. Well, okay, I had three unrealistic dreams. One was to be WWE champion, another one was to be WWE Intercontinental champion, and another one was to win an Oscar. Now, I had three more realistic dreams in the sense that ever since I was 15 years old, I've wanted a Mustang, I've wanted to make a living as a writer, and I wanted to play the game of Survivor. Now, it even went so far as during lunch period, I would write Survivor friend fiction at home and type it out and put my friends on opposing tribes and even some people that I didn't even talk to. And I would sort of simulate an entire season of Survivor with these people of who would win and how things would play out. And sometimes there would be twists and turns and you never really knew what was going to happen. I even got called into the office once for it because two of the people that I wrote about didn't like the way they were portrayed. So fair enough. Now, I review cars on the internet for a living, you know, basically pointing out how a Chevy Nova from 1970 is a sentient mustache that comes from the period where 22-year-olds all looked like they're 36. I met a friend in grad school, and together we launched a YouTube channel that now has over 623,000 subscribers, and with the money we make from running this channel, I've been able to realize two of my dreams. I'm sitting in a Mustang right now. I am making a living writing, and my writing is reaching people all across the world. You know, it's not like I'm going to be a Pulitzer winner or a Nobel laureate or, you know, anything like that. But our car reviews are comedic in nature. And so there are people around the world who are listening to the scripts that I write as my friend Brian delivers them, or as I deliver them sometimes when I narrate a video. And they're laughing and their day is sort of being brightened and their sphere of knowledge is being widened, and it's because of something that I typed out, and that's insane to me, and it's an amazing thing. Now, I'm going to bring this back around to Survivor. Now, the long and short of it is that growing up, I had a very debilitating anxiety disorder, and yes, it was something that prevented me from sort of having a social life outside of school, even if it didn't prevent me from being able to make friends. You know, I made up any number of excuses not to go to parties. I missed my senior class trip. I missed chorus performances. I actually had a panic attack so bad that I wasn't able to perform in a version of The Sound of Music for our high school drama club that was featuring Taylor Swift back when she was 11 or 12, because we basically attended a junior-senior high school, which is 7th grade through 12th grade. And so, yes, she and I are in the same yearbook, and yes, I have spoken to her before, although I've pretty much said two sentences to her my entire life, but it's weird to say that I went to school with Taylor Swift, and no one really, like, predicting what it was she would become. Like, that's insane to me. Especially now. I mean, I'm from Reading, Pennsylvania, and that's the city that produced Debbie Wanner, another Survivor favorite. A friend of mine actually worked with her at Red Lobster, and I actually know her daughter, kind of. Her daughter was the barista at the cafe I was writing in when I first started working for regular cars. So it's kind of this weird 6 degrees of Survivor separation. See, I don't want to be on Survivor just to be on TV. That's whatever. The reason I want to be on Survivor is because I feel like the adventure of it is something that could potentially change my life. As someone who dealt with anxiety all throughout his youth, I sort of grew over the course of my time working with regular cars by narrowing the sphere of my comfort zone. You know, first it was road trips, and then it was plane trips to LA, and then suddenly I'm taking trips to the United Kingdom or trips to New Zealand, and I'm not feeling the crushing weight of anxiety on me. And so now, after all these years of watching and never applying because I feel like I wasn't strong enough to do it, I have that confidence now. I feel like I can do this. And not only do it, but potentially win the thing. Because yes, the title of Soul Survivor means a lot. And yes, I want to be able to high-five all my other Survivor-loving friends so often that I need elbow surgery for it. But I want the money. Like, who doesn't want the money? You know, $1 million is no small chunk of change, and Lord knows I have student debt that would make that whole thing go away. And yes, I've only come to this realization of my own strength in the past 2 years, so I've only been trying to get on Survivor for the past 2 years, which is the duration of a bad marriage or a good war. I want to hear Jeff Probst say Survivor's ready, and I want to be able to hear him ask if we want to know what we're playing for and to be the first person in the world to say, no, Jeff Probst, I don't want to know what we're playing for. I don't really care, because let's be honest, I may not be a huge physical threat, but if I win any challenges, it's probably going to be because people drag me along. And yes, I know I'm selling myself really well right now, but yeah, you know, Chris Doherty was on the chopping block in the first vote of Vanuatu. He wasn't athletically capable, and he ended up winning the thing. Ceree Fields, by her own admission, was a huge couch potato, but she's gone on to become one of the most legendary people to ever play this game. And Sandra Diaz-Twine is a two-time winner, and she's Puerto Rican like me. It's just great to have all these people who've played Survivor and who are like heroes to me. And I know, I could probably give a far more interesting audition video than this. I can go jump off of something very high into water that may or may not break my fall. But at the end of the day, the only thing that's going to get me on this show is showing you who I really am. And this is who I really am. I'm a guy who has a Mustang and who makes a living writing. And the only dream he has left is to be on Survivor. And then I can, you know, hopefully win the thing and give my mom a new car, a new house, my nephew, the things that, you know, enrich his life in the way that he's enriched mine. I can provide for all my family and take care of student loans that have been plaguing me and dangling over my head like a sword of Damocles. I don't just want to be on this show. I want to win this game. 39 days, I'm coming for that ass. Please believe it. So I'm Nick Roman. They call me Roman. And I want to be your next Soul Survivor.
Get a fat dip of that guac.